You think I won't poke her, right?
Yeah.
How? How? Motherfucker, you retarded. You retarded, Teresa. You sound retarded. Cause that ain't how that shit work. I ain't never motherfucker open. You don't open a goddamn book up and say, damn, she's very attractive. I ain't never jacked off to a broad's mind in my life. I ain't never been incarcerated, time out, and I'm incarcerated, and I'm squeezing one off, right? And I'm thinking about a conversation I had with a woman. Stop. Stop.
Have you ever been on a blind date?
What the fuck? A blind date? Hey, sweetheart. Hey, sweetheart. That type of shit for betas and gammas, man. I'm a sigma. No. I've been a beta. I've been a sigma my whole life. I'm a sigma. I'm not an alpha. I'm not a beta. I'm a sigma. Look it up.
What does that mean?
That means that I ain't nowhere in the world I'm going on a goddamn blind date because I don't have to. That means that somebody, hold on, you're not going on a blind date. That means you can't find a girl of your own, and some of your friends felt sorry for your ass, and they decided to pick the girl for you and say, ooh, I got a nice girl for you. That's some beta shit, baby girl. I don't do that. I've been a sigma my whole life. When I was young, I was worse than this is right here. Shit. When I was young, I was very chauvinistic. When I was young. See, when I was young, I beat homosexuals. When I was young, I used to beat the shit out of a homosexual just because they were. You know why? Well, I'm glad you asked why. Because I was 6, 7 years old, right? Some old wise ass sages, right? They were so wise. This is about 16 and 17. They told my 8-year-old ass, these wise 17-year-old people, the facetious, me being facetious, me being sarcastic, facetious. Okay, listen. They told me that at 8 years old, right, these teenagers told me that the homosexual would catch me and stick their ding-a-ling in my booty, right? That shit terrified me. So I grew up homophobic, right? Once I grew up and became a man, a fully grown man, I understand that is not the case. Not all homosexuals are pedophiles. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to say more heterosexual men than homosexual men do that shit. Fuck with kids more so than homosexuals do. There are some people, man, you can see, I would look at two men having sex and say, ugh, that's nasty as fuck. Kill them both, fuck them. You know what I'm saying? That's my personal opinion. Okay? But now, you got two men, right? That want to get married, whatever, do whatever the fuck you want to do, you got all the rights in the world, man. I mean, my spiritual belief disagree with you, okay? With that marriage part, right? But that same spirituality beliefs also tell me this, to live and let live, okay? My spiritual beliefs tell me that a man is a man, and a woman should marry, right? But that same spiritual belief tell me, leave them the fuck alone if they do, right? Okay, no, so you cannot have me go back and say something about how it was in the past. Cause you're talking about the if my son was homosexual, okay, then I'm gonna love my son. I'm gonna embrace my son and just cry cause I never had grandkids.
Coco be out there barking.
That's what the fuck I'm gonna do. I'm going to embrace my son, I'm going to support my son, and I'm going to dead any motherfucker that come near my son because he want to suck a dick and he want to love a man and kiss a man. That's on him. But thank God my son was a bad boy, not a gay boy. That's my personal preference. You know what I'm saying? Hey, my son was coming up, he was a bad little motherfucker, and I seen a bunch of teenage homosexuals, man, and I was glad that he didn't turn up that way. But that's my personal preference. That's my... Hey man, you know why? Because y'all injecting y'all reality into the motherfucking truth. And this is the consequence of y'all actions. The same as y'all, all women always talk that shit about they can handle men in sports, right? You heard that argument before, right? That women is just as good as men in sports. So then why is transgender women dog walking, dominating their fields? They dominating. It's a woman's view. I don't know what the other bullshit is.
What other bullshit? I don't believe that a woman. I think a man gotta play.
You believe that's how? You believe that? You typically trying to tell me that bullshit? No, I don't. You just say and try to convince me a whole half hour that's how I have sex with a woman, with a fat woman.
But I'm saying I believe that we all have sex. The woman has to play for the man.
okay, cool. So old fashioned lady, why are you trying to make me have sex with a weird woman I want to have sex with?
I mean, I'm just saying.
No, you, I'm just saying.
Mental.
What's mental?
Sex is mental.
Oh yeah, of course sex is mental. It's also physical.
It's mental to a man.
So we talking about the fuck we talking about a man having sex with a woman. We ain't talking about a woman having sex with a man. No, right, exactly. So you took that and said that that's the only criteria of me. You asked me, you gave me two choices, right? Mental or physical, right? So do what you gave me.
I believe.
So it means that's how you think, how you feel, right? And I'm telling your goofy ass, you're wrong. You think I'm a poker in the back of a car, right? Because that's your reality, man. That's your fucking reality, man. And I believe behind closed doors, you had sex with a dog. Now where we at? I got a handsome ass master. I mean, King Corsa. He handsome as fuck. Big, sturdy motherfucking dog. And I believe behind closed doors, a woman was sexy to try that motherfucker. Ain't nobody looking at him. I think you're taking a look at his penis. And that's erroneous as fuck. That's dumb as fuck on my part, right? That's dumb as fuck. But here's the problem. Now, if I go out there and start telling everybody this shit, promoting this shit, I sound crazy as fuck, right? And that's how y'all sound. But y'all wanna say how y'all sound crazy, man. Y'all just don't. I don't argue with women. I don't argue with my wife. I don't argue with the woman I've been with.
I don't argue with men either.
No. You gotta do it right now. Get this one right here. Cause see, man.
I'm not a fighter. I'm not a debater, okay?
I can't tell. Hey, what woman ain't a debater? I went in a damn fighter. Hey man, you can't post that video, Kunta. You can't post that video, man. I gotta edit that motherfucker, man. I'm editing that motherfucker, man. I will not be on YouTube talking about fat bitches, man. No.
Big boy.
What?
They're not bitches, they're people.
Hey, check this out. What's wrong with me? I used to be a pimp. That's what's wrong with me. I used to be a pimp.
That's not nice.
I used to be a pimp. Ooh, what?
Huh?
No, right, exactly, man. That's me being chauvinistic. Say what?
How do you say,
in the beginning of my video, did you record it right? I said these words. I apologize for vocabulary. It can appear to be homophobic or misogynist at times, okay? And it does. But, stop! Hush your mouth, child. I also said this. Above all, I believe everybody should be treated equally and fairly and justly. But the only part you keep on taking out is me vernacular. One time, there was two old dudes coming up to the shop. I was right? Part of the body shop, right? Mechanic shop, right? Old dude, I used the word color all the time, right? Color people, right? The shit didn't offend me. I didn't give a fuck about it. That's where he come from. That's the generation. That's what they did right there, right? That shit didn't offend me. That one bit, him saying color. Because I knew the man was not racist. I knew that was the man. He ain't caught with the times yet. This man, you know, he ain't all these different words they put on us, you know, FBA, ADOS, Negro, color, you know, African American. We always get a new one every fucking 6 years. We get some new shit coming out, how to re-identify as, right? So in this man's generation was colored, right? The shit didn't bother me one bit. I mean, the man did business. I knew the man wasn't racist. That's just his vocabulary, okay? Now, mind you, he said that shit in front of a man his age, right? Another man about 67 years old, right? And they fist.
I'm trying to stay focused.
Man, I know you're trying to stay focused. I mean, like, I just say this to the man. Because I say, really, man, I may say fat bitches, I may say homeless faggot sometimes, they come in my mouth, but I know I don't supposed to. Shit, <no. laughs> I know, hey man.
You know what?
What? Marijuana? You want to take my marijuana? You want to kill people then, right? You want me to kill somebody, right? Listen, baby girl, if you take my marijuana from me, I'm going to kill somebody. And that's you. That's you. Right.
Well,
Teresa.
We have to be
respectful. I am being respectful.
Not calling a certain group of women out their names.
Hey, man, check this out. If my vocabulary offends you, I apologize. Okay?
No, it's not that. It's
hey, check this out. If my vocabulary offends you, I apologize. If you listen to the message, and stop focusing on fucking words I'm saying. I done said it 100 times a day. I apologize for saying the word fat bitches. I just sit there and say that I am not body shaming. Stop, Teresa. I am not. I apologize. But do that mean I'm going to stop? Hell no, I don't mean I'm going to stop. Shit, I still say nigga. Shit. Oh, fucking. Want me to change over motherfucking night, man? Fuck out of here. I am not. Motherfucking America. I am not politically correct. Fuck y'all. But wait. Because you got to admit, bitch sounds good coming out the tunnel. That's just rolls out the mouth. Bitch! You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
But, okay,
well, okay, what can you do? Well, how about this? Skinny bitch, fat bitch, dumb bitch, black bitch, white bitch, purple bitch. Bitch. Alright? You happy now? Woman. God has not created nothing. I don't give a fuck what pill you swallow. The coldest thing God ever created was a motherfucking woman. You can't tell me different. Okay, wait. How about this? The coldest thing God ever created was a bitch. A woman. All right, then. Nah, shit. Nope. I'm not talking about the white man's definition of bitch in the dictionary. I'm talking about a street nigga's definition of bitch. Okay? Huh? A bitch is a female. My definition of a bitch is a motherfucking woman that won't shut the fuck up when a man is talking to them. I'm playing. I'm laughing. Them jokes. Okay? Teresa, what you're trying to do, Teresa, is take 57 years of non-political correctness, right? And correct me in a matter of moments. It's not going to happen. You're not going to add water and all of a sudden, I'm not going to speak how I speak. Now, do I work on it? Yes, I do. Do I try not to say it? Yes, I do. Am I near yet? No, I'm not. And if that ain't good enough for you motherfuckers, all y'all get a whole bag of undesirables. Back the fuck out. Now. Hey, check this out, man. Now look what we just did, man. I spent all this motherfucking time talking about some bullshit that don't matter to me at all. Okay? We spent all this time talking about a fucking word. Now all this whole message is about equality and fairness. But you can't hear that part because I said fat bitch. Right? So fuck everything I said about the equality of women. Fuck all the empowerment of the gay. I don't like the word morbidly obese. I can't stand that bullshit. That's a horrible, horrible phrase. Morbidly obese. That's horrible. It's probably as bad as fat bitches, huh? Yeah. But only I don't speak exactly. Yeah, Tia. Hold on, Tab. Let me check myself. Yeah, you motherfucking the same thing, you goofy motherfucker. Fat bitch and morbidly obese. But since I am used to saying fat bitches, right? That don't resonate inside my head as offensive. Thank you. But morbidly obese too, right? But it's the same motherfucking thing. It's a derogatory remark, right? Fair enough, right? But since I'm accustomed to saying fat bitches, this one will fly my mouth from time to time. And again, America, I apologize for that. Do not let the words confuse the fucking message, man. Okay, so stop that bullshit and dig the message, man. And here's the message, man. Bottom line is here, man. Well, that's on you. Stay there. Stay stuck on the fat bitches then. Stay right there. And and guess what? That's why I'm not talking to you. I'm not talking to people with Jerry Springer mentality. I'm not talking to people that are disillusioned. Okay? I'm talking real, the real people are real shit. And if some words that come out my mouth offend you, then I apologize. I am not perfect. Who the fuck is? And I said, you, I'm not talking about you in particular. You're not fat to me. Hey man, hey man, check this out. I am not about to walk through my whole world, man, trying not to offend people, man. I am not, man. If I offend you, man, I truly apologize. Fuck the words to the message. Fuck the words to the message. I ain't talking about you. Why you owning that word, you? I'm not talking to you directly, man. Hey man, check this out. If I offend anybody in my audience, then I apologize. Fat motherfuckers. Right, exactly. How where I come from is that, man? I'm not Kyle Town, no motherfucking body, man. I'm not. Kunta, I don't know, Kunta left, man. He been gone, shit. And now you fighting me, I ain't fighting you. You fighting me. Every step of the goddamn way. You want me to be politically correct, and baby girl, I'm just not. Okay? I'm gonna be me. And if you wanna take one microscopic part of me and paint a whole picture, have at it. Because motherfucker, I ain't talking to you neither. To them. Not saying you, I'm talking about America, I'm not talking to that particular person. Okay? If you cannot, if a person cannot distinct the message from a few words I say, my me not being political correct, I'm not talking to your dumb ass neither, you dumb fuck. Fuck you, you miserable motherfucker, I'm not talking to you neither. Have at each other. What?
I like the way you are.
I ain't, hey, you gonna have to. Because I ain't changed for no motherfucking body. But God.
I see you getting better.
Shut up, guy, man. Kunta, I do not want America, hear me calling them just back. We was not down low.
You talking to the editor.
No, you going to delete that whole goddamn. No,
you talking to the editor.
She don't edit this shit. She don't edit this shit. She don't edit this shit. She just poked the motherfucker. What are you talking about? I killed 10 niggas last year. That's the end of the world. You don't edit shit over here. That's the goddamn problem. Don't edit shit, man.
Hit that subscribe.
Yeah, you like to subscribe, man. But check this out, man. The video I got, man, I'm doing right now, man, is listen here, man. All America been doing is cooking black folks. Let me tell you, you got a pot of boiling black folks, right? Mm. And you boil the fuck out of us, right? Yeah. Anybody know you got a pot that's overboiled, the content of the pot will all come rise out and extinguish the flame, right? Okay, extinction number one. They've been boiling us forever. It was cool at first. Niggas was cool at first. Until they freed us. Now we got too many free niggas. What we gonna do with all these black folks? Let's eradicate them. Let's not give them no rights. Let's not have them vote. Let's arrest them and back into slavery. Man, so many laws back 13th Amendment, right? Look it up. The free black slaves, right? All that shit. They did all that shit, right? So then in the 60s, right? Everybody tired of shit. The pot is boiling. The pot boiled over. Civil rights. All this shit came out, right? So they put the fire out. They gave us a little bit more, but took some away from us. Right, we can do this, we can do that, right? And they cut the motherfucking pot back on. Only this time, baby girl, they don't allow us to boil over no more. All they're doing now is simmering our asses. It's a slow cook, right? They're gonna cook us until we're useless. So right now, the pot's gonna boil over again, right? Let me take the boil over. Killing, the police killing black people, right? The pot is boiling over. Stop! Hush your mouth, child. Hush your mouth. I am talking. Do not interrupt me until I say you can. Hush up. God damn, Teresa. Now, like I was saying, baby girl. No. You hush your mouth. Like I was saying. Now, the pot is boiled over again with all this black killings and shit, right?
That's what he said.
Now, listen, okay? Now, the pot boiled over again, right? They stopped the pot by... Now they prosecuting police and shit, right? Now, because they don't want the pot to boil over no more. You see what I'm saying? So now they're turning heat down. Let's prosecute some of these white people. Let's start prosecuting these police officers and shit, right? Now that they pop out the bullet again, they want to simmerize black asses. And how they simmerize? With the corn pork tail, the minicide, the war on drugs. It was a war on black and brown people, right? Yeah, all this is pop. They're cooking our asses, man, until we're right. Useless. Right. But they refuse to pop boil over again. They don't want us in an uproar. You know what I'm saying? They don't want it to hurt. They don't want it to hurt so bad that we start screaming, right? It's a death by a thousand cuts. They are slowly eradicating the black community, people.
Damn.
Okay? And one of the things they're using is this medium for women shit.
That nigga is neck.
You know what I'm saying? Because the black man, the black community cannot withstand, a man versus woman thing. You know what I'm saying? It's not enough of us to sustain the collateral damage it's gonna cause. Okay? So we all, that's some white people shit, man. Let them have that shit, that man versus woman shit, man. They can have that shit. But black community, man, we got to cut that shit out. We are all, the man's in the lead. We are equal people. The man's got the lead. It's all. If you tether me to my woman right here, my woman is right here. My woman is beside me, and we walking on this journey to fucking success. If the woman is behind me, I can't see her to protect her. Hush, I ain't talking no more. Patricia, be cool. The woman is behind you, right? You cannot protect that woman. If the woman is beneath you, right, you will travel over her. If the woman is ahead of you, you cannot see where you're going, and you got the directions, okay? Woman is beside man to help man on that journey. The man take the first step, she take the second step. The man take the first step beside the man in unison. Stop with this bullshit of inequality, right? The white folks can afford that bullshit. We cannot. We need to be black man, black woman for a stronger community, man. If we swallow the red pill, if the red pill and the blue pill come together, they create the purple pill. Risa, if you say some stupid shit, I'm gonna cuss you out. Go ahead. Hello. I think we lost Risa, man. We lost Risa. She hung up.
Okay, let me ask you this.
Okay. Okay.
According to the Bible, right?
Okay. No. Let me stop. Every man is not equipped to lead every woman. That is true. Find your man that's supposed to lead you. This is true. Every man can't lead every woman. But every man can lead a woman. It's not, see, y'all think what that leads here? Here's a problem right here. Y'all don't want to be led.
I don't know.
Okay then. Okay. Now, if your goofy ass go out there, and get a man, you choose a man that can't speak into you, that can't lead you, ask yourself, why you make such a bad choice of man?
Exactly, I agree with that.
Okay? Exactly. Now, for every woman, there's a man. For every man, there's a woman. Okay? Now, if you want to go get, for example, take what you call a feminist woman, right? You got strong masculine energy, right? Now, in every relationship, there must be a dominant and there must be a submissive. Now, if that woman can find a man, they have a submissive energy, they probably can make it in that relationship. They probably can, right? But no, the problem is, y'all don't want a submissive man. Y'all don't want a submissive man. Y'all don't want a submissive man. Hey, man, tell you that. Hey, man, you know what, man? I'm my baby girl. I love you, baby girl. But I'm finna hang up. Because I'm breaking my rules, man. I don't argue with women. I don't discuss with women. No, we're not talking about Teresa. We're not talking about it. You're injecting your reality in the truth, and I don't do that.
Come on.
No. I don't have my truth. There's not my truth. There's only one truth. It is not mine. You don't have a truth. You have a reality, man.
You don't see, okay.
What man? Well, quick, go to Suckersville and get your goddamn man. You going to, okay, you ain't gonna address that? The reason why the men are not strong enough, man, because men, because the black man is being raised by a single black woman. And they're injured, and they're in, and why is that? Why is that?
Why is that? I'm not sure. Because
I am. Well, I am. Okay. Women are intuitive, right? Intuition based. Men are analytical based, right? For the most part, it's a generalization here, okay? For the most part. Now, when a single mother is raising a son, and she's inputting him intuition, when she should be inputting him to analytical, it's a problem. So now you got a bunch of boys acting like women. Because that's what their parents said. I mean, one time, I'm at the corner of the light, right? The little boy was sitting on the goddamn umbrella, right? With the point end going up his ass, right? I said, hey, little man, men don't sit like that. The mother cussed me the fuck out. Told me I don't tell her son what to do. I said, you right, have at it. She said, you're raising a homosexual. That son, maybe he likes his ass. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But when I try to intervene as a masculine man, tell the little boy, do not put shit up your booty hole, the mama stopped me. So with the little boy here, it's okay to put shit up my booty hole. Come on, man. Stop with the madness, man. Stop with the madness, man. Again, like I was, as I was saying, Teresa, before you so rudely interrupted me, I was... Okay, so what, man? I believe, okay, and that's who Dr. Umar. Dr. Umar is a brother, I like what he's saying, right? But I do not like when he say, I do not agree with him, when he say that homosexuality is a choice. I don't believe that. Why? Well, I'm glad you asked why. Because in 1964, the year I was born, right, if I'm looking down here and God gave me a choice to be black or white, I'm gonna choose white. I'm looking down at 1964, and they beating the shit out of niggas, they can't vote, they poor, I'm gonna be white. So why would I choose persecution? So you telling me a homosexual can wake up, gonna wake up and say, I feel like being persecuted. I think I wanna be hated. I think I wanna be ostracized by society. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Cool. Okay. And your point is what, baby girl?
The point is that some people are born gay.
Okay. I just said that. And I just said that. And you still stopped me from making my point to tell me this what I just told you. This is why I don't like talking to people like that. I have a hard time. I'm a Sigma. When you get off the phone, baby girl, look up and say, I mean, listen, I'm screaming, I'm a Sigma, right? I just found this shit out about 2-3 months ago. What I am. I always thought I was an alpha, right? But I'm not an alpha. I am a sigma. No. I ain't no motherfucking middle. I'm superior. What do you mean in the middle? What do you mean in the middle? Because I'm T.R.E. Williams. Because that's my reality. Is it the truth? Hell no. But it's my motherfucking reality, ain't it? Because I said so. It's my reality.
I'm glad it's your reality and who else's reality.
It's not the truth, is it?
And whose truth is it?
Nobody is not the truth. It's not even my own truth. It's my reality. I was making a point between reality and the truth. In my reality, it's God, Jesus, and then me. And then the rest of you motherfuckers. That's my reality. Huh? Everybody peasants. The whole world. I'm talking shit now. I'm just capping right now. But real talk, baby girl, real talk. At one point in my life, that's how I felt, for real. No, hell no. Are you crazy? I felt that every whole world was fucked up besides me. I felt that you better bow down to me and worship me, because I'm the closest thing to God you ever gonna get, you maggot motherfucker.
Okay, what did you have
that made you think that you're that? My own mind, like all of you motherfuckers think y'all reality is something special and ain't shit. No. I just fucked that way. See, what people don't gotta understand something, right? Reality does not have to be based in truth.
Yeah.
A person's reality is a person's reality. You don't make it the truth. Hey, check this out. Hey, money don't make no motherfucking man. Shut up. No, money don't make no goddamn man. That's a myth too. I did that bullshit too. Money don't make no goddamn man. Hey man, you know what? Oh shit. I'm not gonna take this phone call, man. It's my mentor. I'm home. I'm not talking to you anymore.
Yeah, hello? Hey, what's up?
Hello? No, I don't know what happened.
Damn, room, I was a better man. Yeah, I was supposed to my life, naturally. old song makes that old song. Yes.
Who has the power to stop this?
Yeah.
Man, that was pushy ass.
Fantastic boys. God damn.
I got a pay for most of
it. Ain't nobody gonna do that in this meeting, man. I'll give your car back. Fair enough?
Yeah, I can do it.
I got 50, man. Leave me alone. I'll talk to you later, brother. All right. We gotta cut that shit out, man. All this black man versus black woman bullshit that's being promoted, propagandized by others, all right? Like I was saying, they can afford collateral damage. We can't. If you take red and purple, red and blue makes purple. Purple is a color of royalty. And until we come together, we'll never be the kings and queens that the Creator wants us to be. As long as they keep us divided and arguing about words again with the fat girl shit. Man, I apologize for that bullshit. I don't mean no harm, no foul, baby girl. You're a beautiful person. You know what I'm saying? Just don't try and force yourself on nobody. You know, if you want a skinny man, the skinny man say, I love you, baby girl. Use some pounds, or tell him to kick rocks, one of the two. Accept you as you are, or get the fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? Fuck the devil. The motherfucker don't want you because you exercise, fuck him. You don't gotta have him. God made somebody for you too. I know a whole family of them. A dudes love heavy set women, man. Love large women, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to body shame nobody or less than someone's value because of this, that, or third, or anything, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, all I'm saying is, man, let's cut the bullshit out, man. Men aside, the war on drugs, black and brown people, counterintelligence program, COINTELPRO, these are things and tools they use to cook Negroes, African Americans, ADOS, FBAs, where the fuck you want to call yourself. They're cooking your ass too. They're cooking us, y'all. And now they're simmering us. As you cook, you know that the food will never boil over, right? But it can render the food useless by just simply simmering the motherfucker on a low heat. The guys on low heat, they playing a long game, man. They playing a long game. And we in the black community, man, you can fall for the bullshit. Now I cut them videos, man, because I panicked. I made a video, it's coming up tonight, I panicked, you know, just before I realized that a lot of that shit is Jerry Springer shit, you know what I'm saying? A lot of that shit is people getting money for this shit, you know, so they're getting paid for drama and negativity sales. We all know that, drama and negativity sales. So that's what they're doing, right? But understand what you're doing, black people. When every time you promote division, man, you're killing your community. You're playing right into that. It's the same ass, man. ADOS, I believe in ADOS, I identify as ADOS. Same as ADOS, American, African American, black, Negro, where the fuck you wanna call it, where the fuck you wanna call yourself, FBA, where the fuck you wanna call yourself. If you going around hating Asians, committing hate crimes against Asians, man, simply because some lame said China flu, come on, man. You doing exactly what they did to us. Same as you hating homosexuals, man. You letting these motherfuckers tell you to do bad things to people because they don't agree with you? You're doing the same shit they did to us. Same shit, man. Stop, man. Oh, sidebar. Quit listening to motherfuckers. You wanna get rich? You wanna become a millionaire? Quit listening to motherfuckers that tell you they can teach you how to become a millionaire. And simply to do a little bit better. If you do a little bit better, you'll get there, man. Quit fucking your disposable income off. Another time, man. This is some shit. Me and that lady got into it, man. She hate me going down. She drew me into the same bullshit that everybody else on every other channel do, man. That man versus woman shit. They inject their realities, man, to the truth. And the dog called moving the goalposts.
Yeah, that's bad too out
there. When all they do is insert their reality to the truth, man. There's only one truth, people. It's not my truth, your truth, or their truth. It's one truth. And people interject their realities into their truth. And your reality is how you perceive things, man. It's as simple as that. As simple as that. I know they ain't gonna add the motherfucker, man. I know she's gonna have me out there screaming at fat bitches and shit, calling all these derogatory remarks, man. And again, I apologize for my vocabulary. I am who I am, man. Does that mean that I dislike heavy set people? No. Again, but what y'all gonna do is, everything I say is positive, you're not gonna focus on that. All you're gonna focus on is the negative. And I'm talking to you. I'll probably do a better video one day soon, but not today, man. I'm finna smoke some reefer and relax. And pray God that Kutin will put all that the whole content on his motherfucking channel, which I know he is anyway. With that being said, I'm gonna turn the motherfucking camera around. So that motherfucker, he got a fuck, I'm finna get the fuck out of here. Man, my damn sandwich is cold and shit, man. Fuck on Teresa ass, arguing on her ass, man.
It'll be hard to look at it on there.
Look what I'm talking about on here.
I have to hook it up to a TV or something. It'll be hard to look at it like that on there. It'll be hard to look at it like that on there. I mean, you can, but you know, I can be a second kicker to my brother to the TV. Next time you come over there, I'll better at the TV. I'm watching that on the TV. Because it'll be chopped up in 5 minutes, too. So cut off some 5 minutes. It's easier to edit it, you know what I'm saying? You know, they put them back together and remember. But this one is coming out of the mouth, edited perfect. I mean, great. That way you say, cut the camera off. I figured, yeah, go through your old videos, come up with a name for all the shit.
I'm going to go to the next one.